So show me strong and show me weak. So lots of people talk about wanting a relationship, but a lot of people aren't even subconsciously strong for a relationship, okay, and all that it entails. So this is where we muscle test to make sure that everything is strong, so that the subconscious can be aligned to the conscious. Okay, so nice and strong, and then show me weak to make sure the polarity is correct. Nice and strong. Okay, so think about being in a relationship. Pretty strong. Think about seeing your partner once a week, twice a week, three times a week, four times a week, five, six, seven times a week. Think about seeing your partner 7 days a week. And think about seeing your partner 7 nights a week. Yeah, not so much 7 nights, right? So you want to strengthen Erin to seeing her partner 7 nights a week. Okay, nice and strong. Okay. Now, when Erin thinks about a partner moving into her place, it also goes weak. So we need to strengthen Erin to a partner moving into her place. Okay, nice and strong. We test. Think about someone moving into your place, you should be nice and strong. When you think about moving into your partner's place, it's strong, it's stronger. Right? Mm-hmm. Now, think about being called someone's girlfriend. Okay, think about calling someone your boyfriend. Okay, good. Think about being someone's fiance. Think about someone calling you their fiance. Think about being someone's wife. Think about someone being your husband. Okay. Think about being a wife and a mother at the same time. No. So we need to strengthen Erin to being a wife and a mother at the same time, right? So strong for being a mother and a wife. Then think about being a stay-at-home mother. Yeah. Think about your husband being a stay-at-home father. Not so much. Right? So you want to strengthen Erin. And we're not correcting it so that she attracts a stay-at-home father, but we're just clearing the weaknesses. So strengthen Erin so that she's strong for having a stay-at-home father, right? Whether she has that or not. It's not about manifesting that, just strong for either way, okay? So now, think about having a partner who's a stay-at-home father. Okay, good. Now think about working, having a career, being a mother, and being a wife, okay? Yeah, not so much. So this is why a lot of women struggle, because they're not strong for all three, right? And we want to strengthen Erin for all three. Career, mother, and wife, right? So, nice and strong. So now think about having a career, being a wife, and also being a mother. Okay, good. So when Erin thinks about being with someone who is a father and a husband and someone who also has a career, not so much, right? So we need to strengthen Erin to having a partner who also has all three, okay? So now think about a husband who is also a father and has a career. Okay, good, nice and strong. Now think about your future husband. Think about his family, like his mother, okay? Think about his father, okay? Think about his siblings, okay? Think about his friends. Think about him not having those people in his life. Yeah, that weakens Erin, right? Because family and friends are important to her. So we need to strengthen her to, whether her partner has family, friends or not, she should be nice and strong, okay? So now think about your partner not having family and friends. Okay, good. And if they don't have siblings, she should also be strong. So think about having one child with a partner. Think about having two children with a partner. So we're going to strengthen Erin to having two children with a partner. OK? okay? Nice and strong. Having two children, having three children, having four children, okay? We can stop there.
Please.
Okay, so strong for having more than one child should be strong, okay? Strong for having more than one child. So let's go ahead and clear any relationship karma or blockages or negative limiting beliefs from the father side. 10, 100, 1000, 10 hundreds. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So about 700,000 negative beliefs or limitations or karmas, relationship karmas. Let's clear that from Erin. And we're clearing from mind, body, spirit, soul, conscious, subconscious, unconscious. Okay, and from systems, chakras, organs, meridians, subtle bodies. Okay, nice and strong. And then we also want to clear karma or negative limiting beliefs and stories from the mother side. 10, 100, 1000, 10 hundred millions. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 million. Relationship karmas, blockages, limiting negative beliefs from the mother side. And we want to delete that from the mind, body, spirit, soul, conscious, subconscious, unconscious, from all systems, chakras, organs, meridians, subtle bodies. Okay? We also want to clear Aryans of the lifetimes. So in the 3D paradigm, we call it a past life, right? Because time is linear. But in the 5D paradigm, time is not linear, so there's no past, present, and future. So we just call them parallel lives. So let's clear negative experiences with relationships in other lifetimes, okay? How many other lifetimes? 10, 100, 1000, 10 hundreds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, so we delete those from Aaron's mind, body, spirit, soul, conscious, subconscious, unconscious, and from all her systems, chakras, organs, meridians, subtle bodies. Okay? So, nice and strong. When Erin thinks about meeting someone this year, she's strong. When she thinks about meeting someone next year, not so much. We delete that and correct it, right? Strengthen her for meeting someone next year. Yeah? Okay, nice and strong. When she thinks about being with someone who is black, when she thinks about being with someone who is white, okay, when she thinks about being with someone who is from a different country, okay, when she thinks about being with someone who is American, like Erin, not so much.
Sorry,
delete that. We want to strengthen Erin, right, to be strong, energetically strong, even if the person is American, from her own country, right? We're gonna strengthen that, okay? So now think about meeting someone who's American, like you. Okay, good. Okay, so now think about meeting someone and staying in the country that you're in right now, which is America. Yeah, so we need to strengthen that, strengthen Erin so that if she does stay in this country with her partner, that she's strong, okay? Nice and strong. So now think about being in this country with their partner. Okay, good. When she thinks about leaving this country and going traveling or relocating to another country with a partner, she's very strong. When she thinks about traveling the world with a partner and, you know, possibly a child or two, it goes weak. So we'll delete that and strengthen her so that she's strong for traveling around the world, relocating, and also traveling with children or a child. So retest. So when you think about now traveling around the world with a husband and a child or two, okay, good. So how do you feel now?
Very grounded but wavy.